Well, good Wednesday morning to you folks. Hopefully things are going well with you. I hope you had a good night's rest and you are ready to face the day. I'm going to read to you from the book of Luke in chapter 8. We've been in our Sunday school going over some of the scripture, and just the other day we had a lesson that mentioned this, and so I just want to speak about it just a minute here. In the book of Luke, in chapter 8, the scripture says, "It came to pass in verse 40, when Jesus was returned, the people gladly received him, for they were all waiting for him. And behold, there came a man named Jairus, and he was a ruler of the synagogue, and fell down at Jesus' feet and besought him that he would come to his house. For he had one only daughter, about 12 years of age, and she lay a dying. But as he went, the people thronged him. And a woman, having an issue of blood 12 years, which had spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed of any, came behind him and touched the border of his garment. And immediately her issue of blood stanched. And Jesus said, 'Who touched me?' When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, 'Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee, and sayest thou, who touched me?' And Jesus said, 'Somebody hath touched me, for I perceive that virtue is gone out of me.' When the woman saw that she was not hid, she came trembling and fell down before him. She declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him, and how she was healed immediately. And he said unto her, 'Daughter, be of good comfort, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace.' While he yet spake, someone came and told Jairus, 'Don't even bother. Your daughter has died.' But Jesus said, 'Don't doubt, only believe. Have faith.' And so when he gets to the house, she's laying there, and they supposed that she was dead. Jesus revives her. And there are those that didn't believe, so he puts some of those folks out, but he revives her. So in our Sunday school lesson from one of the other Gospels, we were talking about this, and I thought how it is that Jairus said, "If I can get to Jesus and get him to my house," maybe he thought he was going to touch his daughter. I don't know for sure, but he just knew that he needed to get to Jesus to get him to where his daughter was. This woman with an issue of blood, she needed to get to Jesus. She said, "If I could just touch the hem of his garment, the border of that garment, I would be made whole." Both of them had that faith to receive what it was they'd asked for. Now, this song, and I've sang it many times, I don't go through and see how many times or when. I know I could, but I love this song because there are times that you just, I don't know, I can't explain it, but if you've been there, you know what I'm talking about. You can feel like no matter what happens, man, things are going great. And then it's no time that you can't really explain it. Was there anything that happened wrong? But it's just a different feeling. Sometimes you just need to touch him, right? He touched me is a song. He touched me in the Word of God. Jesus did touch the eyes of the blind, told him to go and to wash. Sometimes we just need to reach out to him as well. Having said that, it's all about him. I've been so down, drifting around, tossed like a straw in the wind, praying and crying, desperately trying to catch just a small glimpse of him. The dimmer my view, the more I'll pray through, till I'm standing right by his side. I've been there before, And in this I am sure it's the only time I'm satisfied. I'm going to touch him today. I might have to push some things out of my way. It might take a struggle like Jacob with the angel as he wrestled to the breaking of day. Cause nothing's more real than the joy that you feel when you let the Lord have his way. It might take all night, but the joy of the fight is that I'm going to touch him today. They say in this world, if you feel the joy of the Lord springing up in your soul, it's just an illusion, nothing more than confusion, and you're bordering out of control. All I can say is if that be the case, then just let me go out of my head. As long as I'm able, I'll go to his table. It's the only place my soul is fed. I'm going to touch him today. I might have to push some things out of my way. It might take a struggle like Jacob with the angel as he wrestled to the breaking of day. Cause nothing's more real than the joy that you feel when you let the Lord have his way. It might take all night, but the joy of the fight is that I'm going to touch him today. It might take all night, but the joy of the fight is that I'm going to touch him today. Lord, I thank you for the day you've given us, Lord. And I thank you for the times when we feel weak, when we feel discouraged, when we just don't know how we feel, God. I'm thankful that we can, through your grace, reach out and touch you. And it is you that makes the difference, Lord. God, we love you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Billy Fields wrote that song. We had him years ago when I pastored another church. We had him come and sing for us, and it was a treat to be with him. He's a great songwriter, preacher, and singer as well. God bless you all. Hope you have a great day. We'll see you Thursday.